Peace, family. Welcome to another edition of 200 Hours, where we give you the side effects and benefits of different hours. Pause. Get your golden love tincture, iris sea moss, orange peels, ginger. Get it. AIHolisticHealth.com. Get it today. With that being said, smash the like button and subscribe button before. Smash the like button and subscribe button so we can get the notifications out. Help me out, please. Share with your brother, your uncle, your auntie, your cousin, your sister, all them family members and your friends, right? Today's herb is peppermint oil or peppermint. Peppermint is actually a crossbreed, a natural crossbreed. From our research, it's a natural crossbreed from watermint and spearmint. The Latin name, Mentha piperita. Piperita. That makes sense. I mean, that sounded right from like what it looks like. Mentha piperita. What happened is that I don't think I mentioned this in the beginning of the video, but 2 minute herbs, we show you the side effects and benefits of different herbs. I don't know if I did that in the beginning of the video, but I just did. So with that being said, benefits. Used for breastfeeding discomfort, heartburn, tension headaches, and relief from discomfort during gastrointestinal exams. This herb has also been used to help with hot flashes, dental plaque, bad breath, pain from shingles, stress, morning sickness, nausea, and vomiting. Peppermint is really widely known for its effects on IBS, irritable bowel syndrome. That's like what it's, I mean, that's not the only thing it's known for, but it is widely known for that reason. Side effects. Some reports of heartburn or burning sensations around the anus have been noticed when the oil is used to help IBS. The leaf and oil may cause heartburn, allergic reactions like headaches, mouth sores, and flushing. Now, of course, these side effects, a lot of the time, majority of the time, come from overuse, from you doing too much of it. Don't do too much of it. Peppermint oil is really strong, so don't do too much of it. Please don't. Don't do that. Don't do too much of any of the herbs in general. Herbs are really powerful. They come from the earth, from Mother Nature. It's the real deal. don't just go out there and try to take 3 drops of eucalyptus oil, 3 drops of peppermint oil, and 3 drops of lavender directly on your tongue and try to swallow that. And you think that's going to be good for you. Don't do that. You know what I mean? Like, use this. It's really powerful. This right here is so powerful. So use it. Use it, man. For real. With that being said, smash the like button, subscribe button, get the notifications out, and share it with all your friends, your uncle, your auntie, your banana, your jean jacket, your picture on the wall. Share it with everybody. With that being said, this is not FDA approved. Consult with your doctor or physician first. But for real though, consult with them because, you know, like I say in every video, we're all different. Genes, DNA is different from everybody else's. With that being said, I love you guys and I appreciate you guys. Pause. Peppermint. I'm going to read the instructions on this peppermint oil direction just so you have an idea. Enjoy the benefits of pure essential oils in a massage, your bath, or in a diffusion. For massage, dilute at a recommended rate of 5 drops of essential oil to 10 milliliters of Nature Choose unbased base oil. Now, the base oil doesn't have to be Nature Choose base oil. It could be avocado oil, coconut oil, or whatever oil. You understand what I'm saying? But as you can see, it's 5 drops, literally drops, 5 drops to 10 milliliters of oil. Like that's not that many, that's not that much of the actual oil to put in, you know what I mean? With that being said, be smart. I love you guys. Appreciate you guys. Hey.